Tavern Gamer.
Alright, welcome back to Tavern Gamers. Today we're going to be playing Element TD2. This one I just got yesterday on sale for like 10 bucks. Definitely worth it in my opinion. Love tower defense maps. And I've been playing them since, you know, StarCraft and Warcraft, all the mods. This one wasn't, I believe in Warcraft was a mod for that. So it looks like they've taken it, the core concepts of that and brought it to their own standalone game. And done a really, really good job in terms of expanding some of the depth and decision making, what you can do. They added some multiplayer stuff, all kinds of extras, so definitely worth checking out. I'm still learning it. Again, I've only played it for a day, but I'm really good at tower defense maps. I pick them up pretty well. But I'll show you guys my thoughts on it and what I've been doing to get ahead so far. And let's dive into it. So we're doing campaign. And if you guys don't know what a tower defense map is, basically you got creeps that are enemies that will spawn from a portal. For example, this blue one here. And they're going to just run through this kind of maze and try to get through the maze to the end point. And then if they get through and we don't stop them, they take our lives away, and that's how you lose. And we're building basically towers that will attack them to slow them down, you know, to damage them, whatever, all kinds of stuff to throw on their way to kill them, ideally before they get to their end point. Now, as you progress, the creeps, obviously, the monsters or creeps, they get stronger, tougher to kill, you get more money, you get more gold to spend on better towers. So it's a constant arms race, you know, whether they win or we win. And there's little bosses that come in certain levels and all kinds of stuff, so we'll get into it. But the core concept is, again, stopping the enemy from reaching its point. And this tower defense, you can't block them off completely like some other tower defense maps. You can only build on your allotted high ground spots, as you see here. It'll make more sense once we get into the map. And let's go into the campaign. So I kind of brushed through just to get some points. So this is chapter one. I'll come back and get the rest of these stars. I don't have a lot of inventory in terms of what towers I can use and unlock, so we're going to be on a bit of a budget build. And we're going to be playing City Outskirts of chapter 2, I guess map 11. And we'll show you what we have to deal with here. We're going to play it on hard just so I can get a better score to get at least maybe 3 stars. Easy, don't get shit, that's just retardedly easy. Normal, again, for me was really easy. Hard is definitely tricky because, again, I don't have all the best towers and all the skill trees I want to upgrade things I want. We're on a bit of a budget. Obviously, if you have everything unlocked and you know the levels and map it, you can play it on these harder modes where the creep just have more health points and so on and so forth. So the way this tower defense works, there's basically two main types of damage. You have your kind of your basic damage, which, let's just call it like armor pen or whatever, that just does regular damage to everything. And then you have your elemental damage, so fire, earth, you know, water, nature, etc. And these elementals all have something they're good against. So for example, the fire is shit against water, but if we do fight a nature enemy, you know, then the fire does more. And they all have like a pro and con, and then against the rest of each other's types, they do normal damage. And then the composite type just takes 90% reduction from all of our elementals, but takes full damage from composite towers, which are your like cannon towers, your arrow towers. But those towers generally suck, so you don't really build them. So really, it's just a matter of lining up your towers to beat the kind of the monsters coming at you, in a sense. And this map will have creeps from the nature type, so we want to definitely bring in something that's good. So 200% water damage, we're going to bring in some of those. So we need to make sure we have water damage, nature, darkness, and fire. And then another thing we can do is combine the certain elementals in the tower and upgrade them and have their own little hybrids and so on. The creeps, these are special abilities they'll randomly have. So every 3 seconds, creep gain 200 move speed boost for 1 second, ignoring all slows during that time. So that kind of makes it annoying for me if I have a bunch of slow towers in the front, you know, trying to funnel them all into this choke point. So I gotta watch for that. And then they got the mega creep coming, which are your kind of mini bosses that are really slow but have a tons of health. And if you leak one, you lose 10 lives. So the game starts with whatever, 50, 70 lives. Right now, and if you lose your 70, the game's done. And obviously we don't want to leak any lives because we want to come with a good score. And again, everything will make more sense once you see it. Now this is our skill tree, and yes, this looks really confusing. So I'm going to reset my points. I have 15 points to spend. These are the different tower types. You have your light, your dark towers, water, fire, nature, and earth. And these are your passive things that you can unlock later, which I'm still haven't played with all of them, so I'm not necessarily the best on optimizing it. But we're going to just kind of shoot it from the hip here. Let's just quickly check what we're facing again. My memory has failed me now. Where are we going? Single player. I guess it's already too late. Oh, go back. There we go. Okay. So we're going against... Yeah, so we need to take water damage, nature, darkness, and... Yeah. Fire, darkness, nature, and water. Okay. Let's hope we don't fuck that up. So let's just put 1 point in. So we need fire, darkness, nature, and water. So we're passing on earth, and we're passing on light. So light, again, the way it works, light is good against the dark, so 200% damage, etc. Dark's good against water, water's good against fire types, fire against nature, nature against earth, earth's good against light. So we got 15, well now we have 11 points left to spend. We got our base towers. We could upgrade them. That's going to cost us 2 points. You can see it on the top right. When you hover your mouse over shit, you're going to see the abilities, you know, the damage type, attack speed, range, whether it does area of effect abilities. Is it a burst spell? It kind of shows you some info. And what on the bottom text, you can see what the tower actually does. And the more you upgrade it, the more it scales. So we'll see if we put any points into upgrading like the base towers, and then you have your hybrid. So once you have, let's say, dark and water, that unlocks, let's say, vapor. It shows you again what you need to unlock it. Or here we go, poison one. You need one water, one dark, and that unlocks this if we put a point into it, and that's what we get. But obviously these towers look great, and as you go down the list, they do more and more, but they cost more. You know, 2700, but these cost right off the bat 175, so you don't have a lot of money. You got to be efficient on your spending. You got to, you know, plan the level out as it goes, and the creeps keep coming. They get harder and more, you know, more of them, so it's just always a constant arms race for survival. All right, let's see what we do. So they're suggesting this one. I kind of like the poison tower, but we have to be mindful that sometimes those creeps will not be affected, or they'll get a little burst of speed. You can get an ice tower. This one I wasn't too crazy about when I tried it. Maybe we get it because we don't have much else otherwise. Solar tower is kind of on... It's all burst, or not burst, this is single fire target stuff. I wasn't crazy. We don't have either of these. Alright, let's see what this second tier stuff is. Well, one. So it's a buff tower. Manually cast or auto cast. Okay. So a lot of tower defense maps in the past, I'd have to micro or basically click on every tower or control them in groups and tell the towers what to do when I wanted to be efficient, which is tedious and annoying. What I like about this one, you can kind of, when you click on them, you'll see when we get there, you can tell the tower what to do, whether you wanted to attack the monsters or the creep in the front of the, you know, the wave coming at you. You can put them in the back to focus that, or just hit the closest one near you, or the one that has the most health, or the weakest one. So that's kind of an interesting stuff, so I don't have to sit there microing all my towers. So that's a nice feature they've added. For now, let's just, well, again, play it by ear. I could just easily just upgrade 1 point into each of these. It'd be kind of boring, but we only have 11 points left, so let's not go crazy. We'll get the Disease Tower. Okay, let's go with the poison one. Oh yeah, so when you click on them, so you can also, they'll have a secondary little upgrade, but it does again cost more. I can keep putting points into that. So level 1 will give us 60 damage, level 2 will give 240 for damage boost. But again, we're using a lot of points here. Some of these extras are nice, but I haven't played with them all, so... kind of like the Vapor Tower, let's grab that. I wasn't crazy about the ice one. Stacking debuffs and AoE damage. Yeah, this one was kind of whack. I'm not a fan of the Infernal Tower. Okay, let's go with the Solar Tower. Let's get this... let's try the well, why not? But we could also easily skip that and go for this other one, Flooding Tower. Let's see this. 500 damage. Some small AoE, consecutive attacks. So just keeps increasing your AoE damage, reset when it switches, so that's interesting. Seems like some kind of sniper tower. Pretty big damage, decent range. I don't know. Let's try it. Fuck it. Let's just give it a whirl. I got this other one I've never seen. This Jinx tower. Applies debuffs. Health percent damage. We got 7 points left. Archdruid Tower. It's massive damage. So let's say I take that back. Oh, okay. So in order to get the Archdruid thing, I need to put a point here. And now that opens up. Yeah, so many choices, guys. Sorry, I'm a bit overwhelmed, so I do want to get on with it, but we want to give it our first best effort. Alright, let's try the Archdruid Tower, or whatever. It'll be an experiment for us all. We'll put 1 point here into the Jinx thingy. Oh, I need Chapter 3, so I can't unlock this one, sadly. I got all excited. Let's try this Flooding Tower, and we'll try to spend the rest of our points, maybe 1 point, into income if we can afford it. I want to at least get... oh, I can't even do that. Okay, so we can't be too greedy on our towers. I think we're going to chop one off here. Alright, let's chop the Impulse Tower for now. We'll keep these two. If we're going to do that, then I want to buff up our Fire Tower and Nature Tower. But again, we're low on money, so that's kind of annoying. Okay, fuck it. We'll skip out on that. We got 1 point left. I put it into passive income, so if you don't spend all your money and you wait to the turn, you get more money. And so it kind of rewards you for being really stingy and just holding your money and then blowing it when you need to. But that can also cost you. The wave comes at you and they just bum rush you, get through your defenses. So ideally I'd still spend it on towers. Okay, so let's say we don't upgrade nature, but we do an impulse. Maybe that's kind of the way to go. All right, let's roll with it. Here we go. So we got 20 waves of shitters or creep coming. That's my little guy that summons towers. This is where they're coming from right now. They're going to be kind of running down this direction. You can follow the arrows to where they're going. And right for now, they want to get over here. But some maps will open up other portals, or they'll kind of switch the portals on you where they come this way and then they come that way, so all kinds of chaos. Then you got to adjust your towers. These are, again, your base towers, your composite type, which is shit. You can't upgrade them so far anyways. You can change them into better elemental towers, but there's no upgraded composite towers. And those are, again, our darkness, water, fire, nature level ones. You can sell the stuff midway whenever you want, but you get like 90% of your money back. And then I think every 5 waves or special waves where they let you sell your towers that maybe you fucked up on or you got to reposition, they give you 100% of your gold back. So that's kind of nice. We're not starting the wave yet. We're going to come up with a plan of attack. So we have 75 lives. We got 1,000 bucks. Sorry, one sec, guys. And you can also show, which I really like, you can see on this little chart here as it comes, it'll show you all your towers, how much damage they're doing, what, you know, you can put it for based on total, how much damage for the last round. So all these little extra stats helps you kind of quantify if your towers are doing work or, you know, that's just, I'm a numbers guy, so I like to see that kind of stuff. Anyways, I know I've stalled enough, but just showing you guys everything. It's a bit overwhelming for new players, and again, I just got the game yesterday, so I can definitely see this being confusing at first. So the general idea, because they're coming from here, we're going to put some kind of AoE tower in the front. So if I place this for 175, we want to make sure it's hitting as much of the wave as possible and hitting around the corners if we can. So either like this or like this is probably fine. So he's gonna build the tower. That's our level 1 tower. Right now it does 30 damage. That's the range of the AoE stats. So it does, again, 200 damage to nature. That's its little bonus. And then we can upgrade it later to a hybrid tower, or just upgrade it to a fire level 2, but that'll cost us 500 bucks. And then you can also change the way, what I was talking about earlier, how you want the tower to attack. So by default, it's going to target what's near, and it's not going to keep focus on. So you can toggle these things to really customize how your tower thinks or how the AI of the tower will behave. So we're going to leave focus off and target, for now, we'll do near. That's what's recommended, but I like how you can change it, so that is very useful. I can also do target the back, but for now, I'll just do what's near. So the next wave, we got fire creep and earth creep. So we want to ideally go hard right now on water damage and nature damage, because they're going to take 200%. So let's get another water tower in here as well, somewhere ideally in the front. I don't know if that's the best positioning. This doesn't seem great. Alright, we'll do that. And what else do we need? We need some nature damage. Okay. Again, we can always upgrade these to some kind of hybrid tower or sell it, so, you know, don't feel like if you mess up, you're like, you're doomed. Let's try that. So if we upgrade this to the solar tower, it does fire damage, which right now isn't necessarily the greatest for us. Again, we can do poison down the road. That could be decent. And we got a vapor tower. It's either that upgrading the fire too, but right now we need to do water damage and right, what else do we need? Just water. Alright, so let's try the vapor out, see how she runs. We're down to 250. Oh yeah, and you can speed up the game. That's the map on the screen. We're playing on normal speed, but if you want to save time, you can make the creeps run faster and kind of manipulate the time just to save you time. But then it's harder to react and control what's going on in case you had to build some emergency towers. Alright, 250. I think we should be okay. but I kind of want to upgrade this. If we can save it, we need another, 100? It's not 75 bucks, or if we can hold out a fire or two for 500. But let's see if we can hold, let's see how this wave goes. Play it at one speed just to show you guys. So, yeah, they're just... Yeah, and this, so far it's easy. Wave one, they're just coming in. You see their health points just getting melted. And we get to see that the Vapor Tower, no surprise, done 16,000 damage. And that's wave one. So wave two should be coming in a bit. Let's get that tower we wanted upgraded. What did we want? We wanted the solar tower. So it takes a bit of time to upgrade, so you gotta be careful when you're upgraded. It's done now. Another solar here if we need to for fire damage, but I am getting a little bit worried that once they get past this, we're gonna start getting fucked. What are we against? We need nature, so let's get our little summoner. We're gonna build maybe one of those range towers here in the back to kind of snipe things. Forget the range on it, so... got decent range, so we got upgraded into this, and then we got upgraded again. 1,000 bucks, but look at the range on that, that's massive. So it's basically a longbow. I'm a little bit iffy if it's worth. I mean, it definitely covers a lot, but I need to be able to kill all these shitters. So, yeah, 13 seconds or whatever, 8 seconds, these are coming, water. We're starting to get a little bit dicey on creep. Alright, let's get one more water here. We're gonna upgrade it. I don't think we can spend the 1,000 bucks, I mean, it's a little reckless. So that's hitting pretty good. Okay, so here's that wave I'm talking about. So we made it to our kind of our checkpoint where we can sell things, reposition. Oh god, they're coming from here now as well. So they're coming from two sides to get to this portal. We only have 855 to spend, and now we gotta cover these sides, so it is getting a bit dicey, but we do need more water damage and nature damage. And I find with this game, compared to other tower defenses, sometimes you can get away buying just a bunch of cheapies and getting away, but in this it feels like you gotta really just hyper focus on a few well-placed ones rather than just going for the level ones and spreading them all over the map. Alright, we're gonna put that there. And we need another water one for this side and hope for the best. I feel like we're still gonna leak on this side. I might have to reposition. I'm gonna sell, see if we can sell this, maybe put one of those snipers in between, kind of in the middle to pick off both sides. We're gonna sell it for now, we get back our 500 bucks. We do need more nature damage. Problem is, this is doing fire damage, this is water, that's poison. And I can't upgrade nature level 2 because we didn't have enough points. That would have been nice. So I feel like we're getting forced into buying this stupid nature thing. Fuck, we just don't have the money. Even if I sell here. This isn't even upgraded. Okay, we gotta hope to God that we just survive this wave. Alright, so we gotta... Alright, so this does water, at least that's fine. Down to 500 bucks, I'm definitely worried because that's coming in, what, 3 and then 18 seconds? Yeah, we need something to kind of catch all. Let's just get this ready. And hope to God we can save the 1,000 bucks, okay? I don't know, guys. Worst case, we might have to respec our skill tree and come back because I don't feel like we have enough damage to stop both sides now. Very close. I mean, if we leak a few, whatever, but I'm definitely not liking this. So far, our Vapor's been doing the most work, followed by our solar towers. We're at 700. I don't think we can hold on too much longer. There's a little boss coming, or not a boss, a mini captain, whatever you want to call it. Like, we got no darkness damage. Just barely. Okay, let's see if this thing's worth. There goes our money. I mean, it's sniping. But attack's really slow. Okay, let's change how we target here. Let's target the strongest one. Now we gotta build some shitter towers. Let's get maybe a darkness tower in. Darkness, we'll have him focus the weakest one because it does more damage based on the lower health it transfers to the other guys. Oh, we forgot to build a poison tower. Maybe we get a few of those going. So poison I want to build in the front. Get a quick poison, they're cheap. We'll do one for this side. We have no dark damage. So yeah, you kill those shitters, you get gold, then you get gold at the end of the turn. That's our interest for not spending, etc. Bosses will give you more money. So yeah, he's decimating this, no problem. If we can get maybe one more upgraded water guy here just to help this side out. Just upgrade it. 500, so there's more AoE damage, starts hitting the secondary targets for 40%, that's not bad. So what does this mean? Two paths will converge into one? So I guess they're just going from here to here. Okay, that shouldn't fuck us over too bad. I don't think we have to resell everything, but we only have 350 something. I think we gotta save, maybe build a few more of these impulse towers. They're doing a lot of damage. But you can't just have a bunch of snipers. You do need to soften them, and these things attack fairly slow. Although they do do a lot of damage. All right, let's start. So we're on wave 10. Haven't lost yet. We still got 10 more waves of this shit to go through. But yeah, you can play with your friends online. You can do different like free-for-all modes, co-op, all this stuff, which I haven't tried yet. It's all new and exciting. So it looks like a lot of fun to be had with this game. I bought for 10 bucks, so it's been really fun so far. I'm leaking a lot on these idiots. So what do I need? Fire? I don't have enough fire damage. Let's get maybe something in the middle here to catch both sides. Maybe another solar tower. Okay, I'm gonna build another one of those solar towers here. Okay, so yeah, this doesn't count as a loss because they've gotten rid of that warper for them. They have to come down this way, thank God. So we got a poison here, we got a poison there. So yeah, this one we need to upgrade into that sniper thing. So let's upgrade that. We got 100 bucks or broke again. So yeah, you can speed it up. So you can hit 4 times speed 7. So all these little features make the game definitely more pleasing. So on those waves, you know you're gonna win easy. It saves you time. What the hell does this guy take extra from water? Oh, and of course he's taking 50% from our sniper tower, which sucks. We're gonna target the strongest one with this tower. And if they do leak, you guys might be wondering, well, what happens when they get to your base and you lose lives? So they don't just die, they go back to the beginning, so you have to fight them again with whatever life they have left. And that gets added to the next wave, so if you start leaking, you can get, you know, that can chain roll into a shitball scenario where you're just getting overwhelmed. Yeah, let's put it back on one speed. I need 1,000 bucks. Just like I'm doing no damage here. Also, these are taking more from the nature, so might as well double dip here. They're taking extra damage. We'll target our strongest enemy. I mean, yeah, it does more damage further away, but I don't want it to do like 50,000 damage to like a unit that has like no life. I really want it to hit the healthiest unit. You can see their life totals here. Or the visual display will show you, but yeah, I really like this little chart. I checked previous round, obviously the impulse towers did the most. Alright, what are these amphibians taking damage? Darkness. I feel like, yeah, we need more darkness towers. We don't have enough of that. Let's get another... maybe another poison. Oh yeah, we got the flooding tower. Totally forgot about that. That's decent water damage. Okay. Let's throw one of those in the middle here. What's the range on that thing? Pretty decent. Okay, yeah, we can try it out here, see how that runs. Totally forgot about that one. Alright, this is our flooding tower. Whenever we can afford it, 1,000 bucks from now. 500 damage, decent AoE. Gains AoE, so this can get bigger, this little circle, and that shows the range. So a little poison guy doing some work. Oh, it shows you the kill count too. Just noticed that now. We're just saving. I guess we could 2x the speed. We need to get the vapor thing going, or sorry, flooding tower. And they're pretty soft. They still gotta come all the way around. I think our budget strat or whatever this strategy on the flagon, first time playing this map, second day playing the game. It is on hard mode, don't have all the towers unlocked, so I think we're doing okay so far. We made it to wave 15. Don't want to get too excited. But let's just finish these guys off, then we'll hold the upgrade. Everything is purple. I don't know what that means. So does that just mean that they're coming both sides at the same time? I don't know what that means, guys. So we'll find out. Let's upgrade this thing. We're not selling anything. We're just going to hit ready. So we want to leave focus on. So the more it hits the same thing, the better the AoE. So we want focus on, because otherwise if it's off, it'll just target the next one that leaves range. But you can toggle that. So for this tower, it's already preset, which is nice. So you don't have to do a lot of guesswork if you don't know what the tower is doing, if it's doing the right thing. I think it presets what it's supposed to be best, but obviously you can change it yourself. But that's a nice little feature to have. So yeah, let's see how this thing does. Put it back to 1 speed. Okay, maybe we get another one of those flooding towers. Put it maybe here. Let me just stack another one here. We're just saving. These guys are all pretty weak. We can upgrade this one to darkness later on, but for now I want to get a second one of those flutters. Alright, let's get it. make a target the strongest thing. So it gets the most consecutive attacks in. Yeah, it seems better. Alright, this bad boy. So we already have a poison here. Let's upgrade this one. So now this thing's doing 12% of their max health to nearby creep on a kill shot. And you want it targeting the... on the weakest one. There we go. Kind of like the tower. Let's maybe put one here. Here, we'll speed it up a little bit. I think I built a poison one by accident. Okay, my bad. I meant to build a second dark tower, like an upgraded dark. Target the weak, there we go. Alright, we'll get another flutter. Okay, we're broke again. Target the strongest one. Okay, two more waves to go, folks. So again, the point of this video is just to show you about the game, show you kind of how I'm reacting to a level, what I'm doing. This is my first run at it. And I'm sure there's, again, a lot of strategies I still haven't found or come across because I'm still really into it. And pretty sure I can definitely optimize my builds later, but just showing you my thought process really and just the game itself. I love tower defense maps, always have, and this one's definitely so far been a nice surprise. What do we got? The stone golem. What the hell is he weak to? Nature. Okay, well, we got those snipers. I don't know if that's enough, but they have done the most damage so far this game. Maybe we shouldn't sleep on another one of those guys. Let's get one more of these sniper whores. And we need $1,000. We're broke again. It's a mega creep. Yeah, they don't take water damage. We gotta hold out. So the last wave. But we haven't leaked anything, so definitely positively surprised and happy about that. We'll see if we get 3 or 4 stars for the victory. I don't think I'm losing at this point. There we go. Let's spend that 1,000. Yeah, these impulse towers doing some serious work. Target strong. Focus on. Geno, we want focus off because I always want them hitting the strongest thing. Otherwise, they just stay targeting it even if it's low, and then I feel like they're just wasting damage. But yeah, some maps the portals will like just appear out of nowhere, then they'll switch it on you, or a new one comes up that wasn't there, so all kinds of unforeseen things. Then you have your boss ones. We haven't seen a mega boss yet, just like little captains. But yeah, okay, so we got our 4 stars, no leaks. And for that we get some extra experience. We'll put that into our skill tree going forward, and that unlocks the next map. So yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed this. Thanks for watching our first run at City Outskirts. We still got this one to do next, but just want to show you guys the game, my initial thoughts on it. Definitely enjoying it, and stay tuned for more videos coming your way. Stay frosty.